Hello, everybody. So here we are now with the fourth and, for the time being, last episode of the third season of Controlix Developer. My name is Christian Zentgraf. I'm responsible for the technical support in the business unit automation of Bosch Rexroth and the host of this show. Last time I promised to you, this time we will be international. We have the honor to be visited by Mauro Riboni, our colleague from Italy. If you take a closer look at his LinkedIn profile, you will understand why I called him last time a nerd in the very positive way. He's not only a nerd, he's also an absolute expert when it comes to IoT. It seems like you're not nervous at all, even though it's the first time for you in our show. But why should you? You are one of our six Controlix developer and it's your show. So I'm really happy that you could join us, Mauro.
Thank you, Christian. It has been a long journey from Italy for me, but finally I made it. And now we are ready to talk about IoT. You know that our IoT solution is open and flexible. It's open and flexible and can be used for any plant or machine. And because in the end, the goal is always to create value. Create value through production data trace, creating an automatic reporting for the machine and empowering the predictive maintenance of the machine, which is really important. And how we can achieve such kind of results? We need to standardize the data mining for the machine, which is really important. And then we can, over this standardization, create something like a knowledge of the machine. And to do that, we need to empower the connectivity of the machine, because the old standards for connectivity are no more good for nowadays.
You pointed out that Controlix Automation is an open platform which provides the flexibility to adapt it to almost any kind of application. On the market, there are some other so-called open systems, but what makes the Controlix core so unique to be the perfect match if you're looking for an IoT solution?
Well, Christian, see, our Controlix core and Controlix OS user can use application provided by us, can also use an application provided inside the Controlix store, so provided by our partners through the Controlix world, and can also start from an open source application and create his own solution, maybe also empowering with real-time capabilities. And in the end, all the applications can communicate using the Controlix data layer. So no matter which kind of application he wants to use, they are able to communicate with an open system.
You mentioned the Controlix World Partner Network. Can you give me a good example of some kind of app which can be used to design an IoT solution?
Of course, Christian. If you're talking about IoT, it's really important to have an MQTT broker. So we have at least two partners which are already providing this kind of feature in the store. And the user needs just to install the application and use it like it's a smartphone without the need to program it from zero.
Mauro, can you explain to us how someone could combine a set of available apps to create a powerful IoT solution?
Of course, Christian. Let's start from a normal situation where we have a machine with motors and mechanics. We have also IoT sensors and third-party PLCs. Okay. The first goal to build our solution is to take all the data inside the Controlix data layer. And once the data are there, we can do whatever we want. We can take, for instance, all the data inside the InflexDB application and visualize them using the IoT dashboard app. And with that, we have created a normal, a simple visualizations for see what the machine is doing, okay? But we can also take all the data inside a Python application and depower the solution with AI and data analysis, like shown by Andre. Okay, and all the data can be also stored again inside the data layer, closing the loop.
Okay, Is this a theoretical solution for IT experts, or is this something that can be used by anyone and it's easy to use?
Well, this is the most complete setup, but is already being used by many customers, especially big OEMs that want to standardize their data mining from their machine.
Well, this still looks a little bit complex to me.
Yes, I know, Christian, that at first glance you can see it a little difficult, but in the end it's really easy. And to prove yourself, and I created two small demos in order, yes, to just show you how easy it is to create a visualization and some low-code code, okay? So the first example is from our IoT dashboard application. We can really create something easy, some visualization for our machine, and we just need to select which kind of graph, which kind of visualization we want to have, and select the data we want to show. And in a matter of minutes and seconds, the user can create his own solution without too much effort. Also, the end user can create his own solution. And of course, also creating your own solution with Node-RED and low-code application is really easy. For instance, you just need to drag and drop some blocks, and you can shape and create whatever you want from IoT point of view. And if it is not enough and you want to create something more low level, something more customized, then you can also write some JavaScript code. And with JavaScript, you can also go deeper inside the solution and create really what you want.
Cool. To me, this looks really neat and easy to use, and yet still powerful enough to cover almost any kind of IoT challenge. You explained Node-RED. I know Node-RED from my Raspberry Pi at home. Does it mean I can use any existing flow and load it to our Node-RED app?
You're right, Christian. Our Node-RED app is just like the normal Node-RED you can install over your Raspberry Pi. Furthermore, you can also have more security because we empowered our application with the security standard that we need in industry.
Security is a good point. If you want to learn more about cybersecurity, just click on the link below to episode number one. So you explained as a low-code solution. What if someone doesn't want to program at all? Can we also propose a no-code solution?
I'm ready for that, Christian. If the user doesn't want to code because he has no time, he has no capabilities, or just want to rely on something already done, we can propose our Device Bridge application, which is an application created by Bosch. And the user with the Device Bridge app doesn't need to program. He just needs to configure some connection. And then in the end, we can reproduce the system we have seen before. Okay, without programming, just using configurations.
So in this context, the name Device Bridge means the app acts as an interconnection between the OT world and the IT world. It provides all the industrial protocols, it can pre-process the data and transfer it to the IT world using all the standard IT protocols, even without writing a single line of code. Talking about IT, OT, it triggers my next question. When you talk about IoT applications, you have to deal with a lot of data. How can you scale the system to cover all this amount of data?
Well, Christian, data management is a really important, a really huge theme nowadays. Over Contrix Core and Contrix OS, we have directly onboard databases so that the solution is standalone and we don't need other things around. Furthermore, with Contrix Core, we can also have an external memory installed so that we have more space for our data, for our databases. Okay, but if the system grows, if you have more Contrix Core and Contrix OS installations, then, and we are talking about a plant, we can take the data directly on the mesh system, okay, so that we are done in a plant. But if the system grows more, and then we need to, okay, not seeing just a plant, but many plants or a system that is really huge, that normally the user wants to see all the data in a single point. And that's why we can also push the data inside the cloud. That's really important.
You explained why it is necessary to scale IoT solution in terms of data management, but what about connectivity?
Yes, Christian. Connectivity nowadays is really important, really, really important. That's why we can take out the data from the most common OT protocols. And of course, our preferred field bus is EtherCAT, but we can also implement the most common field buses that the world uses, okay? And talking about connectivity, we have, yes, normally, like any automation solution, we have both OPCWay server and client, okay? And if we need more ports, more connectivity, we can also extend the system using the Type-C port and install, for instance, a Wi-Fi dongle or an extra Ethernet port, okay, to expand the system to achieve our goal. And all the solution is then also secured by the firewall application, and we can also monitor from from another room, from another part of the world, the Controlix core and what the IoT solution is doing using the Controlix device portal, which is really important for, yes, manage the device from another place.
I know you could go on for hours talking about Controlix OS, but this was the topic of our episode number 2. If you want to learn more about it, just click on the link below. Cool, Mauro. Thank you for sharing all those insights with us.
Thanks for having me. Grazie.
I hope we have answered all of your questions and look forward for your comments. We're at the end of this episode, and that's it for season 3 of our Controlix Developer Series. It has been a real pleasure for me to shed light on those topics of our Controlix developers. Whether it was IoT, Controlix OS, cybersecurity, or machine learning, everything fits perfectly together, and yet Controlix Automation is the most open system on the market and the most secure one. If you want to learn more about Controlix Automation, I would recommend to you to watch season number 1, 2, and 3 all together. You can visit us on our Controlix Automation website, and of course, you should subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you want to stay up to date with our Controlix developers, just follow them on LinkedIn. Thanks for watching, and catch you on the next one to be 2 steps ahead.